There are a couple of other odds and ends about the if statement that I want to briefly talk about. So you know now that the if statement makes a decision. You go one way or another depending on some condition. Now, sometimes your code is arranged so that you don't actually have a decision to do one thing or another, but the decision is between one thing and nothing at all. For example, over here, I've rearranged the code for computing the actual floor a bit. I'm initializing actual floor with the floor, and then I only need to adjust it if the floor is greater than 13, and otherwise I need to do nothing at all. In this case, it is perfectly legal to omit the else part. That's like if you only choose between doing something or just staying in place. It's okay to do more than one thing. You could put other actions inside here, maybe a print statement. Generally, in more complicated situations, there's going to be several statements in between the braces. Conversely, if there is only one action here, it's legal to omit the braces, but we won't ever do that. It's just clearer to always put them there. Makes the code easier to read. Now go ahead and work out a couple more practice problems with Sarah, and then we'll talk more about how these conditions are formed.